Hello, I'm Jennifer with Jennifer Decorates, and in today's video, it's all about the DIY projects my husband did while we were in quarantine, so stay tuned. So since this video is about DIY projects that this guy did, I finagled him into joining me in this video. Real quick, we have been married 33 years and we still like each other. Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Lots.
We have three grown kids, two boys and a girl, and we have three beautiful grandchildren. So we're gonna talk first about the stairs he built. Okay, so tell us about the stairs.
Okay, well, let me start by saying what all of them are thinking is there's no way you've got three grandchildren.
Oh, okay.
But the stairs, so we had the stair, we moved in 2 years ago now, and we had round columns that we squared off, and then we had this little set of brick steps that needed a handrail.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to just put a handrail, decided it was a good opportunity to expand the steps and tie them into the columns. And it was a little more work, I thought, than I thought it would be, but I think it turned out to be just what you wanted, I hope.
It did, because it's so much wider. And the little olays from church when they would come over would just complain that we didn't have the rails, so now they'll be happy.
Yep, I'm off of their...
off their bad list.
Yeah, that list. So our deal has always been, I'll build whatever you want,
yeah.
But I just don't do paint. Painting drives me crazy, so... it's built now, it's ready for paint. Actually, it needs to dry out for a few weeks, and then when you paint it, I think it's gonna look really great.
I think it's gonna look great, and I'll show you some pictures later.
In the foyer, you'd said from the get-go that you wanted to put shiplap in here.
Yeah.
And it's just been something that's been a can, keeps getting kicked down the road, but now with the quarantine, I had the time to do it. If you were trying to do this on a wall, these 8-foot sections of primed wood, it's primed wide, it would have been a very simple project, but ours is 9 feet wide.
Yeah.
So I had to cut multiple sizes and kind of puzzle piece the thing together to utilize the wood well. But in the end, that actually gave it a little bit more of a rustic.
It gave it more character.
Yeah, because they're not all perfectly the same. So that actually added a lot of character to it.
I liked it, and so that left me with the painting. So tip on that one, I just had a can of semi-gloss. I'm all about saving money where we can, right?
Yep.
Most of the time. And I did the semi-gloss, and what was it, from the sanding?
Yeah, the sanding over the nail holes didn't get done consistently.
Right.
So there were smooth spots and less smooth.
Oh, it drove me nuts. So I had to start over, and I did it with flat paint, and then that solved the problem. So I think it turned out great, and I love it. Brownie points. Project number three were these two columns that are in between the living room and the foyer. They were round like the columns on the front of the porch, so I had Scott make them square.
So this is a project I love a little less because it is requires such precision. The columns, the round columns on the porch, I wrap them and then we use a lot of caulk and paint them. They look fine. But in the house, it needs to be very precise, and precision work is not really my specialty. But we got it done, and by the time we got it all putted and painted, I think they look fantastic.
We love them, but you remember what you said right after we got them done, because our two older grandchildren.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They love for me to pick them up and hold them, and they can slide down the post, and now the posts are not here.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're going to say.
So when they come over after quarantine, they'll be kind of sad about that, but I think they look great. So we're in the dining room. He did the wood walls in here right after we first moved in, but during quarantine, he added the wood to the ceiling. And this is a small room, and you would think that the wood might shrink the room, but to me, it just warmed it up and brought your eye up.
Well, this is one of those easy projects that you had on mine, but I had this lumber for this ceiling and the one in the bedroom. I had it for 3 months and just couldn't get to it.
Mm-hmm.
So this gave us a break, and it was a very easy job.
Mm-hmm.
You do have to be careful that you're putting your nails into the joist and not just into the sheetrock, but they weren't too hard to find, and it turned out it was an easy, fun, quick project, and it looks great.
I know, and I love it because we did this in the bedroom as well, but in this, we didn't have as much ceiling to work with, so I had Scott do the thinner side of the tongue and groove. Is that how you say that? Because in the bedroom, it's the thicker.
On this side, it's a 2-inch tongue and groove on
right.
the backside at 6 inches.
Right. So because we had more room in the bedroom ceiling, we did the wider there and it worked out great. So for the last project, we're in our master bedroom, and also he did the ceiling in here. It's beautiful, love the wide slats. But you know I wanted a chandelier, but that didn't work out because we really needed a fan. So I pulled my wife card because we had a TV in the corner and I thought it looked terrible.
Yeah, this is the kind of project you do when you live with a woman who thinks a black TV in the bedroom is a hideous eyesore.
It wasn't hideous, it just wasn't pretty.
So what I did is I used these two mirrors and I put them on drawer pulls. They're kitchen drawer pulls. And so you can pull them open from either side and I built the TV into the wall. Just had to cut out a few studs. I knew this was not a load-bearing wall. Mm-hmm. Cut out a few studs, frame around it, set the TV into the wall, and then run the electric down to the cord to the electric outlet below. And then by pulling these open, the few times that we ever watch TV in the bedroom,
yep.
we can, but the rest of the time we don't have a hideous eyesore in the corner.
Exactly. Thank you so much for watching, and I appreciate my husband being a part of this video. Hopefully I'll have even more projects to show you at a later date. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell. It's gonna tell you when I have a new video out. Everybody stay safe and stay well.